Let me make sure everything was good and set up. Welcome. I decided New Vegas. It's only because I thought of a good stream title at work. Oh shit, I already hit 50. I hit 50 before my alt file. Yeah, it's only because I at work, I was like, I thought of a really funny stream title. So, this is why we're playing New Vegas. So, we did Honest Hearts last time. So now, we're gonna go cry. As we're diving in. Can I even get out of here? Oh, I can. To the first DLC released, which was Dead Money. The DLCs released Dead Money, Honest Hearts, Old World Blues, and Lonesome Road. We did them a little out of order, and that was solely because I kind of wanted the perks from Old World Blues to make my life in this DLC a lot easier. So let's get to it. Dead Money takes you to an extremely dangerous area of the Mojave, a one-way journey until you finish your business. Fighting the environment as well. A toxic city. Dead Money is recommended for experienced couriers. Seek out the radio broadcast. I actually think I could still back out. Let's see. Terminal average. I can hack this. I got hacker powers. I hate when I get those allowances replenished when it's like, I haven't even started. I don't even need like the, I don't even need the experience. Cool. Oh yeah, that's right. This is... okay. Does my laser rifle need to be repaired? Not really, so I can kinda keep it there. I can actually make some ammo? What the hell? I never do the ammo stuff. I just buy ammo. Yeah, I'm a smart player. There's all this free ammo I could be making, and I'm like, nah. I'd rather just buy it. Yeah, I believe you're not supposed to come here until after you beat the DLC. So I think a lot of this stuff's unlocked. For now, it's not. Kind of a shadow, I was like. So now I have some chips. Alright, let's go. I'll take that. Mostly because that just... I already have 100 repair, so that's useless. Excitement and intrigue await around every corner. So that's where the trigger is. All along the winding streets of our beautiful resort. But my rebreather! Or rekindle old flames. Let your eyes take in the luxurious expanse of the open. I love that it's still going. Like, it's still going. Should go even after this. Like, I want to hear. I want to hear the fucking radio broadcast just keep going.
You've heard of the Sierra Madre Casino.
I haven't, though.
The legend, the curses.
The curse?
The foolishness about it lying in the middle of the city of the dead. Buried beneath a blood-red cloud.
Like, pictured here?
A bright, shining monument luring treasure hunters to their doom.
Hell yeah.
The world's most famous stars and entertainers were invited to its grand opening.
An invitation was those are some, like, exclusive prime pictures for profiles. A road to a brighter future. Not just for the world, but for all who came to its doors.
A chance for anyone to begin again. Except
the Sierra. Begin Again is kind of like the start of what I'd call the theme of the DLCs.
Like a big flash bulb going off. The grand opening.
Yeah, this casino never opened.
Ending of humanity. It's still out there in the wastes.
It's being preserved.
Just waiting for someone to crack it open.
Going to Big Mountain first actually explains a lot of the weird shit here. Because, like, it's a lot of advanced scientific technologies.
It's letting go.
That are in this DLC that, like, at first feel odd for why, like, a casino would have this, but then if you play big, Old World Blues first, and we lost all our equipment.
Are you listening? Good. From now on, right. When I talk, listen.
And follow my instructions.
Play stupid. Play clever. Make the mistake of saying no. That collar on your neck will go off and take your head with it.
Great!
It's like that pit boy on your wrist. Except filled with explosives.
A little rain. I love Elijah's voice actor. The voice acting in this game is all 10 out of 10.
Do what I say, and the collar will go off. Refuse, try and run, disobey me. I'll kill you and find someone else.
Damn.
There's no escape from here until I let you go. The sooner you accept your situation...
Yeah, we're trapped, basically. What do you want?
The structure you see above the fountain.
The Sierra Madre Casino.
You need to break inside.
It's a heist!
Heist.
It's a fucking horror zombie heist movie? It's a weird DLC.
Avoid its traps. You'll need to gather a team. As I found, one cannot do it alone.
But we're basically getting...
Around the villa are three other callers like yours.
8, 12, and 14.
12 and 14. Find all three and get them here to the fountain.
I don't know why they were able to leave, but we weren't.
Did you get any ideas about killing each other and taking the treasure of the Sierra Madre for yourself?
A warning.
A warning. All your callers are living. One of you dies, you all die. If that's what it takes to make you cooperate, so be it. Because in some respects, breaking into the Sierra Madre is easier than breaking human instinct.
Greed.
The villa is filled with corpses. Some killed by the dangers here.
Like, this is some by me.
Others... turned on each other.
I kind of wish you could fight other scavengers, but mostly we just fight the ghosts.
Could be theirs. They cared nothing for their freedom, their survival, or each other. The ones brought here live on only in what they've left behind.
Their marks, graffiti on the wall, and victims they've killed.
Some tried to help, left supplies and healing for others who came. Their reward... they were trapped down, killed by others with baser instincts.
This place sounds like a death trap.
Went as far as to leave traps behind them, turning markers for help into death traps for anyone following them. It killed us.
Yeah, this is where my, like, one end is definitely going to come and bite me in the ass the most.
Cut others off from. Too many, many. This place is dangerous. And his quarantine measures, its hazards...
Yeah, he's captured a bunch of people and killed them.
Failures upon failures. You think I wanted to place collars on you to ensure compliance? No. If robots could have done this, I would have sent them. The Sierra Madre is a complicated lock. Cracking it open requires human hands.
Robo brains.
The Sierra Madre has many... defenses, means of screening guests for illicit or dangerous items. Your arrival here...
Yeah, so, like, we're stuck with no weapons and no armor.
The casino, this villa, it takes anything with even a trace of radioactivity. Traces of unknown substances and returns it home. The bunker. The process is automated, and the casino itself has other similar services. I was unable to find a workaround except to send others in as tools. Still, I have not left.
Yeah, he basically jury-rigs like a laser rifle, which is what the hollow rifle is. In some respects,
can help you if you are resourceful enough. This place is well preserved. Few who came here ever returned. All the treasures of the old world lie scattered about, virtually untouched. Search, hunt, craft what you can from what you find. The trash of the pre-war era can keep you alive. Food, knives, more. Use them. Even the villa's toxins.
Yeah, most of the weapons we find are like handmade, very rubbish. I actually kind of like that.
Also, there is one more thing in your possession. A rifle that will keep you alive. As surely as the caller will.
Yeah, that rifle's gonna be...
Get the other three.
Oh shit, I meant to ask more questions. That's all I need to know.
I've downloaded instructions.
Cool. I actually don't think I can talk to him anymore. Fuck.
Countless diversions await. Gamble in our casino, take in the theater, or stay in one of our exclusive executive suites that will shelter you and cater to your every whim.
So alright, so we don't have literally anything.
Opportunity to begin again.
Oh, I only have ball. They took all my ammo too. Oh shit.
And leave the world behind at the Sierra Madre.
Reloading.
Grand opening this October.
Oh, I don't even have any of my art. Wait, I'm balding? What the fuck?
Has your life taken a turn? Do troubles beset you? Has fortune left you behind? If so.
Dude, we are so screwed. I need a melee weapon and fast. Which is why I'm taking yours. And I'm already crippled, and I have... I'm dead. Oh my god. There we go. And then, unconscious, because you don't die. No! Please have food. Well, that's, unfortunate. I'm gonna have to scavenge. Grab as many chips as I can. I might have to go buy some shit. Is there any food? Oh, fuck yeah. My melee weapon is not great. But it's better than it should be. My strength is also garbage, too. There's not even a bed in here for me to sleep in. Great start, great start. Alright, that gives me some protection on my old noggin. I need that. Give me like the most. Yeah, then. Let's do three. doctor's back. Hello, Luna. Welcome to the most Christmassy thing I could find. I'm kidding. It's just what we're gonna do anyways. Welcome to New Vegas. Welcome to horror. I'm not even going in the right direction. I need supplies if I'm gonna make this work. Yep. Okay, not in that direction. I can't even get, like, quick level ups. As I'm level 50. So I'm basically fucked. Take the water, because I'm gonna drink that real quick. Clearing out guys is probably good. Meat. I'm gonna need rat away. I have, like, no health. Acquire over 500 chips. Free shit! Oh, I got a gun. That will not help me at all. I need normal multi-fusion cells. Help. I need stim packs. Okay. Shit, I need stuff to sell you. Return outfit code. Oh, that's actually fucking useful as shit. I didn't remember there being vendors that took caps. However, he has something I want. Take cigarettes. I need cigarettes. They'll get me chips. That is a weird thing to say, but it's true. Eh. Oh, fuck yes! Oh, that just saved my ass. Oh, I even got a police pistol. Alright, I have some weaponry now. I don't need the vodka. Actually, take it. Okay, and I have some normal cells. So that's good. Let's get the fuck out of here. Just take everything so I can sell to get those fucking stim pack so I don't die. Of course. Come on. Come on, little bastard. Fuck. I don't have a lot of bobby pins left. There we go. That was not worth it. That was not worth it. Can't make shit. I can sell, literally, take it. Can't wait in this location. I hate that. I don't think you can use any of the beds in the Sierra Madre. We got Edge. Okay.
Let your eyes take in the luxurious expanse of the open.
Okay, return casual wear. Just keep returning this until I have enough coins. Because eventually they'll be useful. Alright, that gives us some chips. Let's go back to that shop. Because I think I can get Stimpaks from the machine eventually. Just not right now. That's why you explore, kids. Okay. Where the fuck was that shop? Because I need those two stim packs. That is a non-negotiable right now. Stim packs and doctor's bags I think will save my life because my limbs do not exist in this run. God, refrigerators are my friends. The feck was that shop? And I can't just sleep to get shit back. That's annoying. I'll take that. I'll take some water. Those are just cans. Over there. Yes. Give me cat. Give me chip. What the hell's going on over here? I already looted this. Fuck. Okay. I gotta come up with a better system. Fuck off! Food. Do I have any Stimpaks? I have one! I actually had three. Oh, look how... that'll start me all over, won't it? No! Yep! Because I didn't save once.
Begin the theater, or stay in one of our exclusive executive suites that will shelter you.
Oh my god.
So if life's worries have weighed you down,
we're in for a fun time.
From your troubles, or if you just
remind myself to save
again. Join us.
Okay.
Let go and leave the world behind at the Sierra Madre grand opening this October.
This fucking terrible place.
Has your life taken a turn?
Yes.
Do troubles beset you? Has fortune left you behind?
Get gone. Food is valuable. valuable than gold right now. Okay, there's my gun. Melee weapons should only be last resort. Because I have, like, no melee weapon skills. Yes, okay. So you're in here. And you had stim packs. For sale, if I remember correctly. Reload real quick. Only take things that are valuable. If I take everything, I might be here for a while, and it's not gonna help me a whole lot. I wish I could sleep. I don't know why they took that feature away. I forgot I was in here. Wow, useless. So that would have been cool to remember. Not like that wastes, like, I don't think that wastes anything. It's just a waste of my time. I need a gun. I'll have better luck with a gun. Just give me all that shit. And we're not gonna take the booze. We are gonna use this thing. Actually, I have the most of the those rounds. So this is the gun we're going to be using for a bit. I can tank it. Actually, I really couldn't. That was actually bad. I almost died. I remembered to save. Yeah, start wearing stuff off. I missed so many of those shots. It's kind of ridiculous. Obtain meats. God, we are so screwed. I remember going through this and feeling invincible, but that might be because I had more than one end. I actually had the power. You got the power. You can do it, you can do it. Good God. Well, that's no ammo there. Oh my God, am I gonna die? All right. Remember, double tap. These things especially. Fun fact, I think they're one of the few enemies that types that respawn.
Leave the Salida del Sol gate alone. You're not done with the villa yet, so don't stray.
Got it, boss. Fuck. I feel like this DLC would be really easy if I could have brought my own equipment. That's probably why they take your equipment away. I have my own shit. These guys are nothing. Especially because I'd actually have ammo. Alright, that's two down of the 8 million that are in this area. Gotta get rid of you. Fuck. I have one more stim pack, and I don't know how many food items I have left. Not a lot. I'm not carrying on a bottle of vodka no more. Oh, thank God, more shit. Hollow point. Yes. Yes, give me. Oh, I just found fucking 9mm ammo, baby. Which means we're back in business with the police pistol. It doesn't take 9mm, but I have another gun. God, I have like basic starting equipment. Dean, thanks for all the shit. That's two down. I have to go find that vending machine and that other place that I went to that had the helmet. Nah, the knife spear is gonna be better. This is the that's how I'm gonna sell stuff. There you are, my little friend. At least I have some defense on my head now. And there is food in this building. I do remember this place. A lot of rads. I'm not taking that risk. Yeah, my melee and my strength is not high enough to use melee weapons very efficiently. So that's cool. No, we're still exploring. Eat, drink all the dirty water real quick. Let's just get rid of my rads before they start becoming an actual problem. I realize this is a lost cause. He doesn't have caps, and I don't have caps to give him. We still got more exploring to do, though. I'm saving more in case I die. Sucks. This place sucks. I really don't need buffs to any of my stats.
This gate to the Sierra Madre is sealed. Locked. For now. Do as I say and it won't be locked for much longer.
I'm trying, but like, I need supplies. You unironically took like the worst character here. See you later, sucker.
That's the way out after you break into the Sierra Madre's vault. Try to leave. I'll set off your collar.
Yeah, fucking... I'll shoot you. The medical district. I don't have to go there yet. Treasure's mine, assholes. We'll see about that. Find me and we can talk. But where are you? Yeah, I don't think any of the beds can be slept in across the entire game. Or the entire DLC, I mean. Just grabbing everything. Oh, that's useful. That was meant to not be sarcastic. That's actually very useful. Water's useful. Literally any supplies the game can throw at me is very useful at this moment. Like, I'm just trying to get what I can. I kind of thought with my updated strength, but like, no, my melee is not going to be that good. I think melee characters have an easier time with this than non-melee characters. I don't need the cosmic knife. I already have a knife. 3 out of 15. Oh, boy. We're gonna be looking. Yeah, the knife spear I'm just keeping up to date because
watch
it is...
for the villa inhabitants. They're difficult to kill unless you chop them apart. If you can, blow them up or disintegrate them.
Working on it. You can just cripple them with a gun. This is what I picked for like a for a winter game. Suck a dick. Alright, what resources? Fuck. Is there like nothing around here? Like a gun? Took just a slower way to do the same thing. Okay, where are ya? Oh. gonna die. Shut up. I'm still scavenging. Honestly, I need more stim packs. Gotta get all the chips I can find. Gambling is fun. Alright, we're not going to the police station yet. We're going here first because I think it will give me a lot of gear that I'll need to use to survive the other locations. Could you imagine doing this DLC first like you're supposed to? Like, damn. No. Please be a gun. Or the better gun. I need armor. And it's a fucking energy laser pistol. Great. I think you actually have more for that, so we're gonna take it. Sorry, I just gotta adjust my seat. Yeah, I'm gonna turn on God mode real quick. God moding this is actually kind of boring. It's really weird, because, like, if you God mode this, you lose a lot of the fun of, like, surviving. I just want to discover all the locations so I can start fast traveling when I need to. Yeah, of course that still hits me. Piece of shit. I actually don't know how much fast traveling I'm going to do in Dead Money, because I don't remember doing it a whole lot.
Don't go through the gate to Puesta del Sol yet. Gather the others first.
I know. I'm just getting all the fucking locations. Can I even fast travel in Dead Money? I'm actually serious. I don't think I've ever fast traveled. Nope. You tell him. Hey, Ranger. Rescue Ranger. I'm getting to that. I forgot how many, like, audio tracks he plays when you do different locations. Like, I just thought he had, like, the one when you try to leave and then the one at the gate. Yeah, activate hologram. Hi. You do anything? Alright, someone remind me he's there. Actually, don't. I'm not gonna remember. Thank you. Why was I able to do that? That's not even, like, a security one. That's gotta be coming from the police station. Alright, let's find the first sucker. Oh, I'm so not used to the way that this does it. Oh, I'm so not used because I have the fucking... the iron sights on my normal one. Oh, I'm not gonna be used to that. Wait, give me the sunglasses. Okay, police pistol, good. We have more ammo for that, so we'll be using that. Wait, I can't wear both? Well, then fuck the sunglasses. Okay, well, any mods or just vanilla? What am I using? I'm using, it's called, I call it ERP. It's YUP. I'm using that to try to help it be stable. And then I'm also using one... where? In the normal experience, in the non-DLC, I have one companion mod. and that was just for fun. Not like a really expansive companion mod. One of those ones that's just like a guy that will follow you. I wanted to do it modless first. And then I do maybe plan on going streaming this again at a future point. With more mods. Because there are some mods I like. That is also part of it. I have unironically, I think, uninstalled... Oh my god, no, I'm not gonna start messing with those in fucking dead money. I have unironically probably uninstalled and reinstalled this game probably 100 times. Okay. I knew this would be the best place to get some new equipment. I probably should have just bum-rushed here, because now I have a weapon with some ammo. Could use a workbench. Get mods. I think I did at 1.2, but none of them worked. That could have just been when I played New California, which was a bad idea. I still have a bunch of the files still on my computer. Like, my downloads, I think it's just... What I do is, this is how I have to uninstall New Vegas, and then I have to go find where all the files are, and I have to manually delete my mods. Cause I always need a clean install before I start messing with stuff again. Else they're just there. I need it done removed, but that's fine too. Yeah, I want to try out some more mods. I liked the mods here so much that I think I purchased Skyrim just because I wanted to mod it and then I never played it. Because everyone was like, hey, there's even more mods, and I'm like, awesome, and I completely forgot. There we go, thank you. You can't find them. Disengage runelock. What are primitive items? That's odd. I put them... So I used to use a program called... I still kind of do. Yeah, because I go through Nexus to get everything. And they have a program called Vortex, I believe is what it's called. That I've been using. And Vortex doesn't really work for me. Because, like, it allows you to download them directly from it. Okay, that will help me greatly, because now I can actually just buy ammo. So everyone wants to hear about this. And, that really didn't work for me. So now I just drag a lot of files into my programs. And then I use Vortex to double check to make sure I'm not missing a base file I need somewhere. Because you'd be surprised. Sometimes you miss that stuff. What Fire Emblem is this? This is the one where they go to a casino and they rob it. Don't you remember that, Freya? Okay, where's the radio? If anyone sees a radio, I don't know how you can help me. Now, Fire Emblem's... I almost played Fire Emblem today. But, I didn't want to rip my hair out. Because the pack I'm playing is hard. I wish alcohol healed you, but it just gives you stat boosts, which is useless to me right now. Okay, game. That just leaves me outside. Cool. What the fuck? That actually gave me a quick save, so that's cool. Oh, there it is. Get used to that. Your collar is beeping, because we're going to be hearing that a lot. Welcome to dead money. Welcome. Where? If it's not the enemies that kill you, it's literally everything else in this DLC. I almost called it a hack. Oh my god, a bed I can actually sleep in. Shut up, dog. I'll get to you in a second. I probably should have got Dean first, actually, but, you know, I'm not the smartest guy in the world. Now watch, I get Dean last, and I'm gonna suffer for it. There's nothing in here except a book, is there? Nope, but you have guns. Good ammo. Thanks. Why was there ammo in your cell? You know what? Actually, this was a good choice to go first. Because now I have a gun, I have repair for gun, and I have bullets. Because I didn't take melee weapons. Even though I have 100 melee, my melee is fucking dreadful. Probably because my strength is 3. What do you mean requires key? Didn't I unlock it with this fucking terminal? Can I talk to you? Oh. Oh, I have to go to the basement, I think. Okay, so I know this game like the back of my hand, except for this DLC. That's because I normally skip it. And that's because it's just not worth it. And you'll see why as we keep going.
A little farther. Follow my voice. That's it.
Trying to get me killed?
Dog.
Where?
Disobeying me.
I don't really care for any of the Fallout DLCs? Weird. I like... Okay, I haven't played the ones in 4. But I have played all the ones for 3 and New Vegas. I own 4. I just never bought the 2 DLCs. Because there's some good ones. Where the fuck is it? You know what? Don't care. We're moving. The only one I don't... Okay, there's actually 2 I don't like. Fuck the pit. It sucks. I hate it so much from Fallout 3. It's really bad. Man, if you want, like, the textbook example of how to not write both sides are jerks, but you still have to pick one of them, go play the pit, because I hate literally every ending. I hate it. Point Lookout also sucks. But the problem with Point Lookout is not, like, its story, which is hilarious. Because, like, Point Lookout's story is you accidentally stumble upon a, like, decades-old spy thriller between a ghoul in a suit and a brain in a jar. And you're like, that's awesome! And then you play Point Lookout and you're like, oh, this map sucks. You fight these hillbillies that artificially have health and fucking damage resistance. I don't know why. It's just all around a miserable experience. Even though the base plot is kind of awesome. Funny God, because I'm never actually going to use you, because God's, Dog's special ability is actually way better.
Can't let you let Dog out. No, not yet.
Is that in VR? I don't have room for a VR headset in my room at the moment. If New Vegas ever got a VR port, I would play that shit in 5 minutes. I'd make room. I'd go take my dining room and turn it into my new computer room if I had to.
Let me speak to the beast inside.
Shut up.
Then you and I
don't even remember how to get your guys' good talk. Ending. I'll try, but I don't even know if I know how. I'm also afraid, because I wear glasses. I don't know if I could... A VR headset fitting over it just doesn't seem realistic to me. Dude, this game's awesome. Oh, I have to play the audio tape. This is the game. I love this game a lot.
Dog, back in the cage.
How's the modding scene there?
What have we here?
I don't know about VR. I do own Special Edition, and I'm tempted to stream it just jacked with as many mods as I can. Like, I have very little interest in Skyrim as a game, except that it's, like, got goofy mods.
I'd have been an idiot to figure out how to release me from my cage. Or perhaps you are.
Which feels bad, because, like, people have been talking about how good it is.
And the one around your neck.
Like, poor Skyrim. It's probably, like, one of the games that I've heard the most good things about, but I just don't have that much interest, because I don't care too much for its basic gameplay.
I'm the voice of
reason. I played like a half hour of Special Edition, and I was like, man, this swordplay does not feel good.
Now that I'm awake, Dog goes back in the cage. Dog knows I'm here, but can't do anything about it.
Right.
I'm his
Freya?
Conscience.
That is just a Harvest Moon game.
Keep him from hurting us.
You want Harvest Moon.
Foolish things.
And kill people with no consequences? Oh, that's Rune Factory.
Time. Then you come along and let me
Except you don't really kill anything in Rune Factory.
You opened my cage for a reason.
You make them go back to the forest.
I want to know why.
Well. Wow, I did not know. You don't even kill the monsters in Rune Factory. Yeah, you send them back to the Forest of Beginnings. Which is really weird.
That's the easy explanation. The one
I love Rune Factory, but that is such like a weird thing that monsters don't die.
All ills, mind and body. I needed to come out.
Which means technically the protagonist of Rune Factory 3 is immortal, but they never ever talk about that.
Do you see these
also, whoops, I just spoiled a massive plot point in Rune Factory 3, but that game is how old? That's a DS game.
His own hand in it.
Which is getting ported soon, I'm so happy, because it's like so good. It's not as good as 4.
He inflicts pain on himself to silence me. When
I feel bad for everybody that got in through Rune Factory 5, and now they're going to play 4 and 3, and they're going to be like, oh!
He tries to murder me out of him.
Oh, the games used to be so much better.
Angrier. Dog is the beast. We simply change.
We had eye romance in 3.
Like the ones here.
It's gonna play it. Thanks for spoilers. Oh no. Oh my god, that game is probably a decade old at this point. Because I remember... Okay, here's why I remember Rune Factory a lot, despite me playing the games. When I was in, like, my final year of high school, a bunch of my friends somehow...
Chew before he swallows. He's eager that way.
They requested... They had to, like, request it from the GameStop in town.
I feel its electronic heartbeat clicking and burning down below.
3 is really good.
Like before... It was cold and heavy before...
Rune Factory 4 is probably my... I still have to... Okay, I have to re-beat Oceans before I, like, make my definitive tier list. Frontier is not fun. I did not like Frontier at all.
Really? Yet it led you here, to me. And now you're here, and it's burning a hole.
But that might be because Frontier is, like, a direct sequel of 1, and I never finished 1. Or 2. Those games used to be so much better. I still gotta finish 5.
Detach. When segment.
This is a Fallout stream, by the way, and I'm talking about Rune Factory. Man, Rune Factory is the reason I did not play a lot. I can't get super into Stardew Valley.
Dog doesn't care.
Because I'm always like, this combat needs to be better.
Twist it, make it fit until he's.
It's very rigid, and I don't know how I feel about it. I get the point of the game is to farm and. Date all the townsfolk, but like, you can do that in Rune Factory. Rune Factory has fun, albeit repetitive combat.
As if I had a choice.
Oh right, God is a
instinct takes over.
Dog has 2 personalities. One of them is God. God is smart. Dog isn't. They don't have a bomb collar because God ate it. And they're the people who dragged you to the Sierra Madre. Sorry, I talked over this entire cutscene. That's why I'm trying to explain it.
Of course you do.
I believe.
So do I.
They're Nightkin, so.
The key? Why, it's the old man, the one who brought us here. I hid the key on me so Dog wouldn't know.
I kind of wonder. I haven't done extensive lore research, but I wonder why stealth boys cause mental instability. I think they affect your brainwaves. Like, they make them go silent, too, and I think it's that messing with that is what causes it. Because all the Nightkins suffer from some kind of disorders.
Why? Do you have some means of contacting the old man?
Yes.
You don't play it. If you do, I'll find a way to get out
no,
of the
won't.
Cage. And you. I'll murder you. Crush your arms and legs until...
I do not remember how to get your guys' good ending.
No, you wouldn't. If you did...
Oh shit, nope, I wanted the other one. Your special perk is useless.
I'd shatter every one of your limbs to splinters and leave you
so,
here.
So, you get three companions, and each of them have... like a different perk that helps you.
No.
Dogs is very simple but very useful. He eats corpses. And you might be thinking to yourself, eating corpses doesn't sound very useful. Until you remember in this DLC, if an enemy gets all of their HP reduced to zero, they don't actually die. They just go unconscious. So you basically just don't have to waste extra bullets.
Prove it. How?
Dean makes you more immune to the fog poison. And I don't remember what the last one gives you, if anything at all. Which is funny, because she's probably the most, like, kinda. I was gonna say plot important, but I guess Dean is probably the most plot important NPC in this DLC. She's more important in, like, the grand scheme of things.
He is as vicious... more vicious than them. His hunger can help you more than I can.
But why? It's getting when ported to Steam control, and Switch.
Difficult to
probably
fight in.
God, I hope it's on Steam. I don't want to play. I don't need more games on my Switch.
The inhabitants of the villa.
I mean, I do, but like, come January.
They need to be chopped apart, hacked on the ground.
Who's ready for engage?
Difficult to kill,
but not to devour.
And dog is always hungry. If he is with you when they fall, he will fall on them, end them. If I am with you, fighting will be far more difficult.
Yep, I don't even remember.
And so, greed, practical or otherwise,
God, what did you expect? You just told me you suck in a fight.
I suspect the Sierra Madre will be reward enough for ones like you.
How the fuck?
Master, the dog not hear you come in. Too hungry now. That cage door. Master, dog is listening now.
God, you're an idiot.
He can hear you over.
Both of you suck, but...
Master, dog is here. What does Master want?
Dog does have a key.
Here it is. Dog didn't know it was there.
How did it get here? It's almost like you have another fucking personality.
Yes, Master. Master sounds different.
Quieter. Is my voice lower than Elijah's?
Dog doesn't want
my character it. Voice, I mean? Okay, I think my voice is
dog
lower.
Promises.
I gotta get to Elijah talk again.
Yes, Master. Dog waited a long time.
And that's one down.
This place. Want to go back to the base.
Or the church. Miss the church. Hey, that's a Fallout 1 reference. The church is the necropolis. Why do you guys have so much health? I can't tell if you guys have so much health. Or, where is my companion? Ow. God, the police pistol sucks. I would kill for my hunting rifle. I don't even know what... Oh, it's what he said. And as I say, I don't even know what he's doing. Oh, I do not need the bear trap fist. I only really need one melee weapon. And I think bear trap fist takes unarmed, which I don't have maxed. I'm just gonna fucking... Good job! I'm just gonna leave some stuff on his corpse, don't worry about it. Come on, big guy. So your running animation must be... Oh, hey, it's that hologram from earlier. How's it going? Sup? Alright, you got this, dog. Does he? Oh, yeah, he's got, like, fucking triple the health. It's a war of attrition now. I'm not wasting any of my bullets. I'm just as bad as Dean Domino. Hey, what's up? Did you kill someone that has some actual usable loot on him next time? Jeez. I don't need whiskey. Always yell at dog. Yell at dog because it gets hungry. Can't stop it. Yeah, I know. Do you want some of my snacks? I don't even know what food this character even has on him still. Oh god. Yes, just give me all 20 rounds. Thank you. That might have been an axe. I might have needed to wait. I probably wasted some of those, but it's fine.
You return. Why?
Okay, I guess his voice is like lower than mine. I don't know why I had to confirm this. No. Fine, I'll cooperate you. No, we need to get out of here. You suck. I forgot you can actually talk to it. That's supposed to go away. Okay, so I have some supplies, so I'm not completely fucked. Dog, I don't even think is the best combat of the... Yes, I know. You want to go back to Mariposa base, but Mariposa is destroyed. The church, I think, is also destroyed. I can't remember, though.
Picking up signals near your location.
Yeah, shut up.
Watch for traps.
Where? I think this lets me skip, like, a good part of this area. Which, by the way, it's Dean time. Great. If it's Dean, we get to talk about the worst thing this game ever did. I think like, Dean's just, like, right up there somewhere. Which sucks, because I still probably am gonna... Hey, buddy! Alright, dog, you do the rest. Where'd you guys go? No, I don't need any books. What the fuck? What do you mean I never got that achievement? Oh, right. Playing with mods deactivates achievements. Except, I don't know why this combination of mods doesn't. Fun fact, there's actually a mod that reactivates achievements. I've never gotten it to work, though. Which I think is very funny. Oh! Dog, fight. I feel like I should be losing karma for this. This is an evil action. I am baiting my friend into fighting my opponents for me. I take like two shots and it's like, dog, go! Sick him! So hungry. I knew that was coming. Because I'm smart. Yeah, I know. Why is there a trap? I thought I was fucking dead. Yeah, dude, let's feed dog. Wait, no, the enemies are his treat. Those are his treats. Alright, Dean, you piece of shit. Because I know you're the one that fucking did all these traps. Yep, there you are. Watch me use VATS for the very first time. Am I doing damage or is like the couch somehow clipping into this? This is what 100 guns still. The police pistol is a bad weapon, let's be real. You cannot win. Bullshit. Okay. Did he go away? Dog will be pissed. Yep, that's just drugs. Alright, Dean, where are you? Am I gonna noclip to your location? I don't want to, because that would take the fun out of blindly fucking up. I did not mean to open that up. Oh, yeah, I also have some mod manager, I think, down. Man, I actually forgot I have a few. I have, like, a mod manager that's downloaded, and I think I also have the 4G patch, which I think just helps performance. Forgot I got a few other things to sort of help the game run a bit better. There's a lot to try to get this game working properly. Will you give me the shotgun? Because I think sometimes they do. Ah, I remember the old days. When I had to, like, hope and pray. One advice that I don't do anymore is, like, it's like compatibility mode. Which, like, is never fun. It also didn't work half the time. This is why New Vegas needs, like, a patch. Am I just back at the beginning? Yes, I am. I didn't even find Domino. I just did a circle. This is why I think this game needs a patch. Like, this game does not need a remake or an update. Or, not an update. It does not need a remake. It needs a patch. Just, like, a big bug fix. That's all it needs. This game is perfect. I've often stated that instead of a remake, they should do... I know this is probably not going to be what everybody's choice is. I gotta move my seal. But I would pay, like, for a $5 DLC that would be, like, a patch that fixed the game, plus the re-implementation of some quests. Like, I would pay $5 for that. Just have it as a DLC or something. Now, granted, they're not gonna do that, because remaking New Vegas probably is way more profitable, because they can sell it as a $60 game. But I can dream and hope. Where the fuck are you, Domino? I love that these are just all Domino's fucking shit. Like, I think if you get to him, he's even like, ah, did you enjoy all my traps? And it's like, fuck you, dude. Dog, I'm sorry. We're trying to figure this shit out. But I have not played this DLC in years. It's not like Honest Hearts, which I was able to beat in like 3 hours. Which is sad, because I liked Zion. It's a cool location. It's just... the core content can be beaten in like 5 hours. He's above me. I know he's above this location because he's on one of the roofs. It's just getting there that I'm having a problem with. See, I'm trying to stay off the ground is because I know he's on the roof. I'm not. No clipping. We will figure this out. I swear I've played this game before. It's like right... it's right up there. He's right in that little hidey hole. I can't even like shoot him to try to like get him to come down. Well, this is new. There's a door I haven't opened yet. Hey, Dean. Okay, now I know we're getting close. Why do I have so much, like, shotgun ammo when the game has not given me a shotgun? There you are. Alright.
Have a seat. Have a seat. Came all this. The Sierra.
I like this. It's the only time you have to sit down for a conversation.
She the one who invited you. Or maybe you didn't catch her.
I love this design. It's amazing.
Woke up confused like some of the others.
And I'm probably gonna change you out for dog just because your resistance to the poison gas is gonna be slightly more useful in the long run.
No matter how uncomfortable that chair gets, the cushion's just for show.
Okay.
Might be a bit rude.
I'll explain after the conversation why I'm deliberately avoiding skill checks.
Get up without my permission. I'll blast your ass so far through your head, it'll turn the moon a cherry pie red. So, let's keep this sweet and polite.
This guy is an asshole, but I like him.
Just because I work in entertainment doesn't mean...
does that guy have shades know that he's the rightest dude alive?
My necktie beeping. I know what that
you're gonna change that tune when we learn more about the story of this place.
I want out of this contract. And if you put me in it, I'm not going to be too happy. So whatever's going on...
God, those sunglasses even look like the same ones they give you in fucking Code Vein.
You're taking orders from me.
Which, yes, I did play. Oh shit, that's the check I can't pass.
Good, good. Then we're in business.
Okay, so fun fact. In this DLC, if you want to make sure Dean gets his best ending, or like you don't have to murder him, you have to not pass one of... I think it's that 50 barter one. And you also have to not make him upset. Like, you just have to like play along with him being an asshole. Or else you have to kill him. It sucks.
Alright, alright. But you already got company, so tell you what.
Yeah, let's keep dog, I guess.
I'll meet you at the fountain. Don't have to take the long way back. There's a shortcut across the ice. It's through the cloud. But if I'm with you, I can help you through
it. Yeah, speech check or checks normally help you. But for some reason in this one, if you pass one of them,
inside's growling.
It hurts you later. You also don't know that's gonna be a problem until, like, you get to that section at the end of the game. Which is annoying. Okay, I just saw the pun in chat. God damn it. Get it? It's like radiation. Punch the guy to death. Thank you. By the way, any limb crippling actually kills them. Which I find very funny. I don't know why I still have a cosmic knife. I don't actually want it. The knife spear is better. Or is more useful.
Where is Master? Did he go away?
No, he's right here. Actually, I don't know where Elijah is for most of this story. Like, he just sort of shows up near the end. I'm not wasting any money because I need it for some items later. Mostly when I get the access to Stimpaks.
Well, his comm speakers have aged poorly, like the Madre. Pre-war junk.
Pre-war junk.
The speakers emit a signal that'll set off your collar if you stay too long.
So shoot him.
There are damaged speakers and shielded ones. The damaged ones are destroyed range. Don't get close. You can't switch them off like a radio.
I don't know why. It's weird. These things are annoying. Hey, do you like beeping? Because we're going to be hearing a lot of it now. Don't worry, dog. You'll find the enemy eventually. Don't worry, I'll just be chugging food behind you. Why do I have scotch on me? And vodka. Disgusting. We don't do drugs here. Well, I hate that they never have anything on them. They only have, like, melee weapons and stuff. Which, I'm glad they don't have guns, and I'm glad you don't fight a lot of them, because, boy. These things exist. Oh, God, it's the cloud.
Where is Master? Did he go away?
I don't even remember where the holo rifle stuff is. So there's a very good chance I am not going to find any of the stuff I need. The holo rifle is unironically one of your better guns, but or one of the better laser rifles. I didn't even hear the fucking beeping. Thanks, headphones.
Villa's comm speakers have aged poorly, like the Madre. Pre-war junk. The speakers emit a signal that'll set off your collar if you stay too long. There are damaged speakers and shielded ones.
The shielded ones are the worst.
Range. Don't get close. You can't switch them off like a radio.
I know. Yeah, I don't really do a whole lot of damage with this thing. Oh, actually, wait. No, that was actually pretty good. But... hey, guess what perk is really useful in the Sierra Madre? Bloody mess. Like, no joke. It will save you a lot of time. There we go.
Always need more.
You'll be fine, little dude. Or dude. I need to check places because places have loot that I need. We're not going back up there. That's when I died. Don't worry, my ultimate plan to send my ally to do all my work for me. Man, this really is just Fire Emblem, except instead of sending a bunch of troops, I'm just sending Dog to go die. Don't worry, Dog. Yeah, I don't believe that for... Wait, hold on. I thought you were stuck on the clinic side. Wait, there's still stuff I wanted to do.
Always yell at Dog.
Dog, stop getting stuck on things.
Can't stop it. Always need more.
Dog, chill. What ending for this should I go for? I mean, it's probably kill Father Elijah, because I don't think I have enough sneak to realistically do the trapped ending. Like, let's be real here.
Swallowed something bad. Tastes like burnt wires.
Why did you do that? Wires aren't food. Is that right away, or is that alcohol right away? I actually like how much food plays into this. Like, food is way more valuable as a healing item than, stim packs. Which I think is cool. It's a cool addition. Or at least it, like, it makes you think a bit more about, like, I guess healing. Get out of the building until I can scout it. I think it's a radio. I was shooting the sign. When did I last save? Oh, it's probably when I got out of the clinic. Yeah, because that was an autosave I just got. Okay, now I know where everything is, so it's much faster. Also, it's kind of cool, too, because, like, cigarettes are something I don't pick up. Like, they're a decent money item in the Mojave, but they're not, like, super useful. Here, like, they're one of your few... They're, like, the money item to get you more chips. To buy you good old stuff. There's, like, nothing. None of these very hards are all that useful. They all really like the master, which makes me feel bad. Oh, now you figured it out. Lame. I like it better when your AI fucks up. I mean, your pathfinding's okay. Yeah, companion pathfinding as a whole, I think, is... like, okay. Do I really need another police pistol? I have, like, 4. I want to get all that gold. Oh, yeah. With 180 carrying weight, how much gold do you think I'll be able to get out of here? If your answer is 0, you're probably right. I cannot remember what the max number is. Somebody figured it out. Somebody actually went through and figured out how to get the most amount of the gold out. Mad respect for you to keep commenting this whole time. I mean, I kind of play games like this. That's actually not a joke. Some of these are just like my, like, just thoughts. But I have a hard time with other games. Like, I stream Fire Emblem, I stream JRPGs too. And, like, sometimes I have nothing to say. Or it's just me repeating stuff, but... I try. It's also New Vegas. I always usually have things to say. What the fuck? Like, I have played this game so much, and I used to spend hours on the wiki.
Picking up a new meta signature. Watch for signature.
Not editing it. I just was on it.
Don't shoot them. Attacking them is useless.
Okay, there's stim packs, so that is very helpful. That's a hangman. Hangman Alan Page? Alan Page? Adam Page. Oh, That was actually pretty cool. Oh no, the Hanged Man. And New Vegas. Oh no.
Swallowed something bad.
It's kind of weird, it's like the Hollow Rifle is the only, I think, good item. The Sierra Madre armor that I have not is not very good. I used to frequent the wiki a lot, and that's because it was, I liked it. The wiki's good. I like the Fallout wiki. I don't like when I get linked to stuff in Fallout 4 and, the new stuff. 14, is that better than, nope, 16. I am still gonna take it. Yeah, I mean, like, I played 3, and then I went back and I've played 2 and I've played 1. The only one you'd probably see another stream of would probably be 3. Just because 2's mechanics always confuse me. Probably in a way that just makes me feel dumb, but also it's just like I never really understood it. New Vegas and 4. 1 and 2 are good games, but I feel like, I don't know, better games I think have come out that have done like the isometric view since. And 1 has a time limit, which I'm not the biggest fan of.
Swallowed something bad. Tastes like burnt wires.
I think the version you'd play now if you played 1, the time limit is like mostly irrelevant, since they made it so long that you have to be screwing with it. I think I had to do that, but I had to go find out I had to do that. Okay, well, hey, it's the Autodocs. I haven't played that game yet. I probably won't. Just because I have a million other games I need to play. I am trying to limit what I buy. Because I have too many games. You know, I have an objective marker for a reason. Like, I am attempting. Yeah. The only one that gets a cutscene, and oh boy, this poor girl. She is, without a doubt. Yeah, it's one of those things where, like, especially with sales coming up, I always try to be like, I'm not going to buy anything new until I've completed X amount of games, and then I'll buy like 50 stuff. Snow coming. Interesting. Like, I guarantee I will walk out the Steam sale with like 8 new games. Plus, like, whatever I just end up buying on my own. Jeez, mute. Ugh. She got really fucked up. Like, my backlog's not as bad since I've gotten through a few things. I got a few of them. I have stuff that I think I'm almost guaranteed I'm gonna buy. I have to look at my Steam wishlist again. But there's a few things. And then come January, I'm still debating or not. It's probably going to be a yes. But I still have the new Fire Emblem, because that's what I primarily stream. I have to say the word primarily. What the fuck is mine? Some of them are games I probably won't play again. Like, I own a few fighting games. I have to look through my Steam stuff real quick. I can think of five of them off the top of my head. And two of them I've already started. I just haven't finished. There are a bunch of roguelikes I've started that I have not finished. Now I'm looking at my library. There's these two JRPGs I have. But to be fair, I stopped playing the first one. Another one. I own the first two Baldur's Gates, apparently. Yeah, good. Good lord. Nope, I'm gonna make myself sad. I have so many more. Freya, you need to play different games. I'm gonna buy you a different game. Actually, I can't even make that joke, because what I plan on getting you for Christmas is a visual novel. Not a dating sim, but it has dating sim elements. For some reason. Oh, right! She interfaces with the speakers. Which is more use- they're actually all pretty useful. However, a million hours of Dwarf Fortress. I gotta play that. I gotta play more. I played for a little bit. Dwarf Fortress is awesome, but it's one of those games where, like, I'm gonna have to have, like, a TV show or a podcast or something between us. Or something between. I just read the line. Or something on. She's an interesting character, but we'll talk to her about her. But I'm gonna need something, because I can't just... It's one of those games I can't just, like, play. I think I'm using this stream right now. What? You're not paying attention to every word I say. I'm kidding. Same with Rocket League. So I am with roguelikes. You ever think, wow, how the hell did he play almost 200 hours of Binding of Isaac? I'm paying a lot of attention. Merry Christmas, Harvester of Ghosts. Okay, well, he just knocked that guy's head off. I'm gonna be really sad if I don't remember where any of the audio all the, like, lore is, because the lore of this place is actually cool. Like, I like the Sierra Madre as a location. I like the story they tell. I accidentally shot God. But, it's one of those things where, it's like Honest Hearts, where, like, there is some cool stuff, except I don't know where all the lore stuff is. On the front page of Steam. I genuinely don't know. Oh yeah, that's been on my front page. I tried to ignore it. Okay, so I love Steam, but I wish Steam would stop recommending me every fucking porn game because I play anime games. Like, those are not the same thing by a long shot. I only own like two games I would consider not safe for work.
Good. Well,
four if we want to stretch the definition and include Monster Prom.
And your part in all this. The owner of the Sierra Madre.
Like, I don't own any games that are like actual nudity.
To the gala event itself.
But no, because I play anime games, they're like, ah, you like porn?
Casino doors to open, as I've discovered. one person can.
I mean, that's also what I kind of figured VR would be used for first.
You're so close now. Don't let me down.
I'd be able to do this in one stream. Otherwise, that's actually kind of cool.
I'll have to rely on the next team. I've unlocked the west and east gates to Cuesta del Sol and Salida del Sol. Now that you've survived the villa, I need to get to my position. You don't need me to hold your hand anymore. I'll keep monitoring you via the transceivers to the villa. If I need to offer guidance,
I will.
A display of lights.
Yeah, it's fireworks. Like, I definitely own some games that kind of toe the line in the anime department between not safe for work and not, but, like, I don't play them very frequently.
The bomb struck first.
Like, I play any JRPG, and it's like, ah, you recently played a JRPG. That means you like porn.
Travel to your position, reach the lead to Del Sol, and trigger the game. After that,
well, yeah, just torrent that shit.
Perhaps you think this is a simple robbery.
I know nothing about torrenting or running a torrent VR game.
This is a heist of the centuries.
I'm assuming it'd be like everything else, but I don't know.
Plundering history, taking from the old world itself. It won't let its secrets go easily. Not without a fight.
Yeah, Dead Money's also kind of short.
Anything less.
It and Honest Hearts are kind of short experiences if you play with a high-level character like I am.
I'd suggest taking the FEV reject to his position first.
And then Old World Blues takes a bit, but that's because it has a pretty robust side mission involving gathering everybody together. And Lonesome Road will take me 3 million years because, boy, that game will just kill me at every moment.
Use your team as I use you.
That's from the trailer.
Watch where you step.
That's where I get a little annoying. I know, like, we're... I have seen the trailers for the New Vegas DLC for a lot. To the point where, like, I used to be able to, like, specifically point out where they appeared in the DLCs. Saw Master in Sky. And to make myself even more sad, I'm pretty sure I can recite the entire Old World Blues trailer off the top of my head. I don't know why. I like watching the New Vegas trailers, whether it's the base one or the 4 ones. There
were things to pull. Hard to pull, but Dog did. And
oh my god. I'm kind of like that too. I buy some stuff. Like, I bought... Well, I mean, I enjoy a lot of the stuff I buy, but I buy a lot of games and then I just never play them.
Then there was noise.
Like, Rune Factory 4, I had already beaten on... Streets. I think 2 separate occasions by the time I bought it on Steam, and then I still haven't finished it.
It's inside Dog now. Dog,
they promised updates.
Hear the noises.
And I still don't know what they updated for the Steam version.
It'll hurt you inside. The lights were pretty.
I can I can do speech checks on anybody else, no problem. And a lot of stuff just keeps coming. There are too many games coming out. Honestly, yeah, there's just too many games. A lot of AAA ones haven't really been that interesting to me. But a lot of the, like, smaller games have kind of caught my interest. Peggle. Dude, Peggle's a classic, though. Slick.
Master went away until you show up with him on your arm.
That's enough for now. Let's get out of here. Let's actually do the mission. Wait.
You are the nice voice. Hard to pull things? Dog has to.
I did all that and he didn't even come with me. I thought that was the dialogue, Shane.
Are we going there? Dog not want to stay and pull things. Hard
yeah,
to
I'll find. I always find shit. I'm pretty sure everybody who's had a Steam library what the fuck? How do I get you to follow me?
Here, followed voice in air, then here.
I feel like anyone who's had a Steam account for like over 10 years definitely remembers the old sales when you would buy a bunch of shit for like pennies and then you would forget why you had them like days later.
Cage. Dog doesn't like being locked voice in air didn't say anything about a cage and nothing to...
Because, like, the flash sales used to be so good.
Dog hears many voices.
They changed all that because they couldn't fix their refund policy or something, and, like, I'm so sad.
Master is the nicest.
They're not bad, they're just, like, kind of boring. Like, everything goes on sale, but they go on sale of, like, when they would, like, what the price would normally be on sale for, like, the midweek stuff. So, like, if you're looking to buy something on sale, like, I'd still wait for one of the big ones, but, like, the summer and winter ones used to be just these massive events. Because, like, not only would everything go on super sale, and some stuff doesn't even go on sale. Like, some shit doesn't. And it's annoying. But, like, it's one of those things where it's, like... And, like, the flash sales would be like, oh, something's 50% off. Well, now it's, like, 90. And it's only for, like, an hour. And that's when people used to buy this stupid shit. Yeah, they're the same. You have to, like, wait a while before before the game.
Lost it. Got home.
Like, I swear, I own Cyberpunk, but I think I had to wait, like, a full year or something before it was 50% off, which is when I purchased it.
Dog is listening. Dog is ready.
Oh, that's it.
Where we go?
And okay, maybe it hasn't. I think it actually, wait, it might have. I don't know. I bought it earlier this year, I think, and it was 50% off. It was already 50% off. I probably will stream it, because I am still interested in it. Despite its disastrous launch, I've heard the game has improved immensely. Okay, so 2 years. I've heard not only did, like, I think it's the 1.5 patch apparently fixes most everything, which is dope. I've also just heard consistently from people that, like, the patches have fixed most everything. And I'm willing to believe them, because The Witcher 3 ended up, like, releasing in, like, such a horrible state, but it works fine. Speaking of that, if anyone's watching does not own The Witcher 3, when it goes on sale, buy its Game of the Year edition for, like, $10. Does not disappoint. Like, I think I've played through that game twice now, and it's so good. I might stream it. I might. If I can figure out a way to disable the ultra not safe for work content. Like the actual nudity. I guess I could just not do like the romance quest. Fable Vandiver. I was gonna buy it, but then I realized I just didn't really. Where did you come from? No, kind of. Well, it's better in 3. I'm just gonna say it's better in 3 than it was in 2. I've heard rumors about 1 and 2, and they're not great. Freya's a completely different gamer than a lot of us. She plays a lot of visual novels. I don't. Well. But we don't really, but, you know. I don't play visual novels because I just get bored. Like, even the ones I've completed, I'm surprised that I've, like, completed.
When dog catch a ghost in plastic, dog tear him apart so they don't get back up.
I just prefer gameplay. Like, I'll play JRPGs that have, like, a lot of, cutscenes and stuff. But, like, then the gameplay happens, and that's where you get me. Like, Kingdom Hearts. Which I have played way too much. And it's probably on schedule to be streamed next year. If the Epic Games Store has a winter sale and I can buy it. I really wish it was on Steam. But that's mostly just because I enjoy having... See, it really depends on the game series. For me. Because, like, sometimes it's really good. Like, just everything. Sometimes the combat doesn't really matter. I'm thinking of a lot of JRPGs right now, where I'm, like, way more interested in the story. Actually, I have 3 guesses, so I can just do... Yeah, I don't know what I was doing. What does this even do? Turn speakers off. Thank you. Turn them off. I'm gonna have all these fucking cigarettes. I'm not even in prison. That was a really funny joke. No, it wasn't. Okay. Where am I going? Dog, where are you? Has anyone seen my dog? Hey, you can't hit me up here. Okay, well that's just cheating using explosives. Where the fuck is my companion? A friend of mine's? David Kip. That's true. Oh, you didn't like Heavy Rain? Or Fahrenheit 451? Whatever the fuck the other game was called? Where is my friend? Okay, this is retribution. Oh, there's a fourth one! Hey. I haven't played it. I'm not gonna comment on it. I will comment on it. David Cage is the guy who wrote it. He's, Would you... Where the fuck are my boys? Okay, well that was cool. Yeah, everyone dead? Nope. Look. My comment on Detroit Become Human is... He's mostly about how... Okay, well, no one but me is gonna know what I'm talking about, but... When 01 was airing, everyone was making jokes about how it was better. How it was just Detroit Become Human. But it was the better. Okay, well, that was a fun fight. Where the fuck's my friend? Did God die? That actually is impossible. Okay. I cannot wait in this location. He is... Where the fuck is he? he's like trapped on level geometry. Why are you over here?
You are the nice one.
Follow me. Why were you just chilling in a room somewhere? What the fuck were you doing? That's it. Did I praise the fucking pathfinding earlier? I take it all back. The pathfinding sucks. Now is he following me? Okay, follow. Come on, doggo. Nothing but. Yeah, I don't think so. Oh, now I know what fucked up his pathfinding. Wait, no, I have no idea, because I. Dog, if you could have followed. Oh, is it because I went on that thing? It was probably because I went on that thing. Dog is the worst. What ventilation system? I don't know if that helped.
Why are we here? Dog not want to be here. Place too much like a cage for
I'm dog. Sorry. If he's a good boy and deserves time, he deserves a gun listen. Or something. Want a hammer? Quiet.
Dog doesn't understand. If dog was fed like last time.
What do you mean like last time?
Voice could make dog stay. Dog not want to be in cage.
I forgot how to get you to stay.
Why are we here? If
hold on, I'll talk to God real quick.
Dog, back in the cage.
So here we are.
A row of switches all lined up. How familiar.
These switches won't move themselves, after all.
No shit, God.
There must be some trick to it. Now that I'm here. You can lead
me to water. No. Being trapped in this courtyard while the lights are flashing and sirens are screaming. I'm not even reading the line correctly, fuck.
One or two of the inhabitants. More than that, even dog would have to work to keep full without being carved to pieces. And the gate here, if it somehow got locked, it'd be the holding cell at the police station again. No. If you needed his teeth to devour those metal switches, chew up the diagram. There's a sequence, precise and
then why the hell am I making you do it? I mean, I know you're the only one strong enough to hit the switches, but also
instinct. No. You think you can figure out what to... Of course you can. I'll stand at my post.
Good, because otherwise I'd have to make you hunt down a bunch of enemies, and that would just take way too much time. Yeah, his, like, thing is you have to make sure he's fed. So you spend, like, hours, and it's annoying. But with skill checks, you get blocked because you don't know what you're doing. What the fuck? Man, you get all these chips, and then I'm gonna have no use for them after a while. I'm not even, like, trying to find all his stashes, but, like... Man, his stashes kind of break this experience. Like, remember when I was, like, scraping for resources, and now I'm, like, not? It's like Honest Hearts. Like, they try to, like, limit how much you can bring, and it's, like, never works. Although I like Honest Hearts. I like what they try to do. The one kind of advantage of doing this DLC is you get an infinite... You eventually get basically an infinite source of stim packs. As long as you have the chips. Which is actually nice. It's actually nice to have. Except we're in the end game, and I think I have like 80 stim packs waiting for me back home. So, like, this is completely... How the fuck did you die like that? Wow, I found none of the holo rifle upgrades. Where the fuck are they? I'm not gonna look them up. If we don't get them, we don't get them. I have the laser.
Sir, what's your story, beautiful?
And frowns. You're barking up the wrong tree.
Was that him floating above the fountain, the boss man? The one who put these bow ties on our necks?
I'm gonna kill you.
Sure does like to make a presentation.
I'd love to, but I've never actually gotten your the ending where you live, so we're trying really hard.
Supposed to be the grand opening of
the Sierra Madre.
Lots of lights, music,
the works.
And he's going to use the gala event to open the casino? But
that's interesting. I'm just avoiding all of the checks because I need to. I think it's that barter one, but I actually don't remember. By the way, the reason that the check will eventually piss him off is because he thinks he's you're condescending to him. Like, man, he's a dick.
Everything in town like a hornet's nest. Not sure what a hornet is? Forget it. Basically trouble.
Tourists, you bet.
They don't stay long.
Yeah, he calls outsiders tourists.
If they survive the cloud, the ghost people, the traps,
then greed takes them over.
And they start sizing each other.
His bow tie isn't even straight. If you're a dick to him, you have to kill him.
Sure.
It's weird. He's like really difficult and kind of infamous for not being getting his like stay alive ending.
They start weighing the odds, taking risks, and then taking each other out. Bomb collars are not. Although, it's odd. The bomb collars weren't linked before like they are.
It's really weird, because, like, I like Dead Money. I think I like Dead Money more now than when I was a kid. Because, like, it changes the gameplay so much. But my big issue is that besides the holo rifle, all of the unique items are not very good. You get the 45 weapons for and two really decent melee weapons for the mid game from Honest Hearts. You get some pretty good end game laser weapon equipment from Old World Blues. And you get probably the best endgame armor and weapons from Lonesome Road. Dead Money's kind of just there. The police pistol kind of sucks and isn't really worth bringing back to the Mojave. The armor I'm wearing is decent, but I think if you can reach this point in the game, you probably have access to combat armor, which is just the same thing but better. And easily repaired. And a lot of the melee weapons and stuff, I think, are just inferior to things like the Super Sledge and the stuff you can find in the main game.
Alive's a tricky word.
The only thing that this DLC is pretty good for is, one, the upgraded holo rifle is actually pretty good if you get all the upgrades.
They're a little uncivilized.
And what else? The gold you get at the end can net you a bit of cash.
Tried talking to them, bribing them, leaving food, nothing.
But it's like, it's the DLC I would say is the least worth completing. Like, if you... I don't know. I'd still complete it if you really, like, wanted to 100% everything. Because it's a fun DLC. But it has a lot of frustrations. Especially for non-melee characters.
Stay out of their way. They don't die easy. If they find out... No. Looks like a rooftop in Puesto del Sol.
In better days, nice view.
Now, it's the last place anyone wants to stand when this event goes off. That place during spring, summer, and fall, a little bit in winter,
is a prime resort spot for the ghost people.
Not the best of
top-notch voice acting.
If we're going there,
I think that's one of the things that surprises me the most whenever I replay New Vegas, is like, the voice acting in this game, I think, is 10 times better than even some stuff you'll see nowadays. Like, everyone has character to their voice.
Strike up the band. Domino's back in town.
Also, just good writers. Like, good voice acting can only get you so far unless the writing's really good. And I think the writing in New Vegas is pretty consistently really good. Like, it surprises me. It's a shocking revelation. God, I'm about to waste a bullet. Okay, which one was... Oh, it must have been one of his lines. I hate the ones that are I hate the Wild Wastelands that are specifically based on somebody saying something, because I always miss those. Are they? Fun fact, these enemies constantly respawn, which is very annoying. Could you die? Why are there three of them? And not only are they bulky, but like I've said, these weapons are just not the best for dealing with them. I don't remember using the police pistol as much as I am this one. And I just fucked up. Do I have anything better? This is probably gonna be a bit stronger. Well, Domino is dead. Not dead, dead. Oh, he's still alive. What the fuck? You used to open in Paris. Paris might be completely dead. Game, can you please blow off a limb? Fuck! I think automatically crippling one that has just resurrected, I think, does that. So the game doesn't completely hate your guts. There's a big area over here. What the hell?
Ah, aren't the trees lovely this time of year?
I see you with that bomb. What's going on in Paris in the Fallout universe? Probably nothing good. I hate that he makes me do the final blow. That's just a waste of ammo. Can you give me some of your 9mm bullets? I probably would be doing better if I could fire more consistently. I just tear off this guy's leg. There we go. I kind of wonder why he has this power. I know he's a ghoul, but... So don't worry, I've got my construction hat on. Needs a key. I don't have a key. Fuck. So coming in here was useless.
There. The switching station. That's where you'll need to bring the mute.
Supplies or traps. Yeah, I've started to notice that. Or I could just not. Jesus Christ, those gas bombs are dangerous. Well, this thing is useless. Yeah, I kind of figured with the better fucking DPS. Because my better crits are def- Why is this its own separate thing? What the fuck? Hey, dude. What the fuck? That's really good. If only I had any caps to give you. So weird, because like you can sort of trade with them, but you can never have positive or negative caps. Is there anything else in here, or are you just like a shop? Why'd they leave all these good supplies behind? Pressure cooker, two ovens, two sinks. That's a kitchen for you. Hey, Domino, you know where the fuck we are? Nah, I don't care. I'm trying not to bring any of the books, because that's just wasted. Space. I thought I gave those back. Yeah, I guess I didn't. What the fuck? I really don't know what the hell happened. I really don't know why the hell I have those in my inventory. Because I should have given them away when I finished the one quest. Dean, I think I encountered a bug. Don't worry about it. It's Fallout New Vegas. Am I? I honestly don't think I've ever actually been to this location. There's not really much useful stuff besides that shop, if I'm gonna be completely honest. Ah, my reading glasses. We can't win every fight. There's actually no point in me fighting if I can get past them. Bye-bye. Get over here, you daft bastard. Fuck. Oh, I have to go back there for him.
You're at the Ghoul Scaler area. Now make him stay.
Alright. Activate the hologram. Maybe it'll start murdering things for me. Thank God. Oh, Deanie boy. Gentlemen. I'm gonna shoot you in the back like 80 times. Where the fuck is... Oh, God. I gotta go track him down, don't I? Every AI partner ditches me when I ditch them. Can you believe it? And he isn't even on my mini-map. What the shit? Nope. You know, I'm just gonna wait for him to come back alive. Go, my hologram. But where is he? Seriously, like, what the f- Seriously, most of them would have respawned and just come back to me. Now we're gonna play the hunt for Dean. If anyone sees him, I don't know. What really sucks is I can't fucking wait and have him come to me because it won't let me fucking wait. So there goes that idea. Hey, I found him. Seriously, the 9mm shit is definitely gonna be better because I can get off more crits. Glad the security bot only attacks the enemies and not me. Because if it attacked me, I'd be probably dead by now.
So, this is where I'm supposed to put on the show. Raid better venues, let me tell you.
Dude, I've raided better venues.
Wiring? Looks like it's tied to the sound system in the villa.
Except yeah, who the fuck snipped it?
So, what? I stand here, hold the two ends in my hands, and tap them together like cymbals?
Yes! Wait, that sounds awesome. Can you do that without dying, please?
Well,
safely.
Around here, that word doesn't come cheap. Look, I strike up the speaker system. Going to be ghosts.
Well, just run, or like lay some trip mines or something, dude. That's not my problem.
The ghost people are not speaking.
Big on talking. Big on listening.
Hunting. Killing.
Damn.
More vicious than music critics, trust me.
Are you sure about that?
In the middle of town, tell you what. Why don't you just give me one of those space-age cosmic knives so I can slip my...
Yes!
...be less painful checking out that way. No, you're not the type, but accidents...
I'm not the type.
...intentions or no. Look, you could offer me a steel-clad contract...
The hell did I gain karma for that?
...of all major cities with imperial records, I still wouldn't stay. No, you want to know why? Because there's more
beneath the streets
and the buildings and no, everywhere else.
Great.
They hear anything out of the ordinary, especially music screaming through the speakers when I close the connection.
And then you have to die.
Be here fast. Well, yeah. If the hologram system still worked, that'd do the trick. Okay, all right. You call up some of those old worlds.
I already did that a bit.
If I remember correctly, do that.
Okay, so I got one of them already. I think I might have screwed up getting his good ending, but whatever. Man, I should have just let him go off the roof. Fuck you, Dean. Nope, I gotta get up there somehow. Hi. You didn't hear me say fuck you, did you? Good. I don't think you would have cared, but... The holograms would be able to buy you some time.
Sure glad one of us knows what to
do. Yeah, it's me. Okay. Jump. Do not fall down, please. I could probably do this. Oh, dude, what the heck, man? I'm fucking... It's like I'm flying. Ah, that was weird. I don't know how I got that glitch to work. That was super weird, guys. Flying glitches, am I right? He's just standing there. You know, it actually would have been really helpful. Oops, did not want to go through there. Actually, that calls you to respawn and despawn, so, like, I could have used that earlier if I was smart. We've got a million of those outfit return ones. Where the fuck are the things I'm actually looking for? Knowing my luck, I've probably already passed them, and I can't get them. Dean, are you gonna fucking follow me or not? Where are you? Oh. Word to the wise. Drain multi-fusion cells. Sup. Did I just... Don't worry, Dean Domino. I'm definitely not going. That's because it's poison. Poison doesn't need those things. How are you helping me? I'd like an explanation. It's not radioactive, which is good. It's just poison. Wait, where is it leading me?
Didn't think much about.
Okay.
You powered the holograms up. Well, yeah, that's pretty good protection.
Invincible holograms will destroy your enemies, Domino.
The ghost people away.
Deanie boy.
But how do I know the power won't suddenly go out?
And oh my God! I'm going to punch you in the face.
Sounds risky to me. For me. Well,
yeah, that thing's been up for like hundreds of years, dude.
All right. Look, if the holograms are here to keep me
if I have to kill you, I'm not actually going to be sad. I forgot how much of an asshole you are.
But listen. When this thing goes off, try and get into the Sierra Madre without me.
What could you do? What could you possibly do? I mean, I know you actually have like plot importance, but I'm going to kill you when I get the fucking chance. Go turn on the holograms, Rousedower. You're expendable, Rousedower. Dean Domino can suck my dick. I should have taken his ammo. Fucking tell him. They're practicing their gymnastics routine, I see. Next time they jump me. Turn on the holograms. I did, Gex. I'm gonna buy 30 stim packs. So lonely without people trying to murder me. Careful of their gymnastics skill. Yeah, they got fucking 10 agility. They took the tumbling feet. I see. I was using a Pip-Boy. When the hell did Elijah get a Pip-Boy? He steal one? Oh, it's my Pip-Boy. I'm gonna show her that. I'm not gonna, like, not. She said it's the exterior of the case. I'm just gonna wait. I wonder. What if she actually figured out where he is? That'd be kind of cool. She's gonna kill Father Elijah. I forgot there's an intelligence check here. Yeah, she also sustained some brain damage. Not just getting her throat slashed, which I just realized you could see on her model. Oh, that's nice. I must have not paid attention to her model so much, because she's way more cut up than I remember. So, in the backstory, Christina here is a former Brotherhood of Steel member that was basically decides to chase Elijah down after he steps down as their leader. And during the pursuit, Elijah just chucks her into an auto dock and lets her do this. And just lets it fuck her up. I'm not gonna ask why she's bald. While not confirmed, it is heavily implied she's also the girlfriend of Veronica, a companion we have in the base game, that she mentions a few times. Which is a cool tidbit. She's an important character. She also knows Ulysses. Her original voice can be found in audio logs back in Old World Blues. That I don't think I listened to, because I'm just forgot to. But it's kind of weird, because, like, Elijah, Christina, and, like, Ulysses get more characterization if you do Old World Blue. He just fell from the sky dead. Okay. Yeah, wasn't I over here before? But I think this is the last of the beeping sections. Where the fuck are we? Where is it, though? I have enough of my repair skill. Ghastly, great. Yeah, she helps out by those things being less of a problem, which is nice. Is it pointing down? Oh, treasure's all mine. The one good thing is they actually do have, like, pointers, which I actually think is really cool. This looks like a Brotherhood of Steel place. And oh, joy, look at all that gas. I think we're supposed to go the other way. Whoops. Yeah, whatever. I got it. Oh my god, my health. You know what I'm glad I just grabbed 40 of? Stimpaks. What are you pointing me to? I did not check what I was doing. Uh-oh. As long as it's not very hard, I actually think I'll be able to do it. Okay, good. Good, 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 good. Turn speakers off, stats report. Damn, there's just a dude here. Already? What? What exploded? Oh, there was a tripwire. I'm dumb. Just like sat there and waited for it. Why do I play video games? I'm not very good at them. I don't care, the suits are here. Yeah, they got these cool radiation suits. So what's really funny is the reason the Sierra Madre has so much tech is because they made a contract with Big Mountain, and Big Mountain's like, yeah, well, I use this experimental stuff. What could go wrong? The cloud, the ghost people. Literally everything goes wrong. I don't even think you can bring it up to them when you go to Big Mountain. Missed opportunity. Because, like, you can actually find the ghost people's armor at Big Mountain. Okay, I don't know what that does, but I'll take it. Oh, ventilation system. Activate ventilation system. Fuck. Can you help me fight? Yeah, whatever. I need to run. Come on, come on. Very easy terminal, huh? Luckily, I'm a hacking master. Said, lucky I'm a hacking master. Come on, game. Wait, there's only like three options. Alright, that takes care of that. Wait, could have I turned the fucking turrets on my side? Oh, good. I could have disengaged that lock I already picked. Oh, there's the key to his locker, which I also picked. There's a lot of stuff I already did. Oh, that just made things easier for me? What the hell? Did I not do this any of the other times I've played? I guess not. We learn new things. Aw. We're giving her comfort. I, the courier. The most evil man in the world. Oh, I get
the bell tower. That's where you'll trigger the gale event. It's a ways up. I'm sure you'll find a way to climb up there.
Elijah? You're going to die. One day, my friend, I will come with vengeance. You won't know what hit you. I thought this spawned enemies in here, but I guess it doesn't. It just gets rid of the gas on your way back. Good source of experience if I needed it. Man, having a melee weapon build would be so much better. And then I remember what would happen if I played a melee weapon build and let's say did Old World Blues, and then I would just cry. Gotta put a fucking tram or something in here. Some kind of terminal station? I'm taking that out of spite. I'm gonna sell that magazine and no one will care. Father Elijah, if I told you how much I hate your guts. No. I hate you. You know, I haven't played Rocket League, but I've heard that's the general consensus. You saw nothing. Weapon repair kit, hell yeah. That's why I don't play online games. Because now I know if I suck, I know it's me. This didn't even help what I thought it would help, so I cheated for no reason. I got a few that play some online games, but not like a whole bunch. Like, I used to have some buddies that play TF2, and I still have like one buddy that does. But I don't play with them a whole lot. Like, I don't play TF2 with them a whole lot, I meant to say. I still have Counter-Strike for some reason. I used to play it. Not anymore, though. Because they changed my favorite game mode. They made it worse. And then I own a few, like, online games, but I don't really, like, play them. Like, I own Dead by Daylight. I have Payday 2, and I don't think I've played that a whole lot. And then I've got a few other games? I'm trying to remember what all I have. I really need to, like, segment my Steam library, and one should just be games with friends. You spooked me. Yeah, I got a friend who used to play a decent chunk of it. And then I've played it with my buddies a few times. I never really got super into it. Stagel's death. Okay. I have, like, 11 bullets. I have a lot of bullets for this gun. If I don't need to kill, I don't need to fight. Fuck. See, I can see that. Try and get me, bitch. Fuck. I need to go up there. Where the fuck am I supposed to go? Just gonna kinda shimmy on the rooftops until I figure it out. Do I stream often? I try to stream 3 times a week. They're kind of random days, sadly, just because I work. And then this week's all messed up because I not only have more work, but there's also the holidays. So this week's probably not super representative of how much I stream. Oh, there you are. But I usually do, so I have 3 different days that I stream. And I do that because why do I never announce it? I forget, Freya. I forget. I'm just like, I'll just stream. I'm a line cook. That's what I do. So, and then the 3 days I stream are all, there's like different stuff. So, right now it's like Wednesday is New Vegas, or it's like whatever I'm playing. Thursdays are usually, or the second day of the week, so it's Thursdays currently, is whatever JRPG I'm currently playing. And then Fridays and Saturdays, or the weekends, that's Fire Emblem Day, because that is what I mostly stream. Yeah. It changes a lot. It's kind of random, because my work schedule changes a lot. It will probably change next week, so that's great. I try to keep people informed on Twitter, but I don't particularly enjoy using that platform. I like the free food. I actually just like work. It's one of the reasons I like, I'm gonna die. Oh. One of the reasons I like working as a line cook is that it's, you're normally busy. But yeah, and you can get kind of a general idea of what I kind of stream. I think I also have a link to my VODs channel, because I upload all this stuff to YouTube. That's mostly to keep myself archived of what kind of stuff I do and what kind of stuff I stream. It's a little bit of everything. A lot of stuff people aren't really looking for. I stream the games nobody wants to stream. And New Vegas. Kind of feels like that actually sometimes, but yeah, I try to keep people updated and stuff, but it's sometimes hard. And like I said, this week will not be super representative since there's a good chance this might be my only stream. Yeah, the traps suck, but we shall see. I work tomorrow, and then I'm seeing friends on Friday, and then I have no idea what I'm doing for Christmas Eve yet. Yep, definitely unconscious and not dead. I don't know if I'm gonna go see family or if they just don't want to see us this year. But we'll see. So then hopefully my schedule next week is pretty similar. Yeah, I'm just gonna get the fuck out of here. That's weird. I mean, I'm lucky. All my family live in the same state. And I have the holidays off this year. I did last year, too. But I didn't have Christmas Eve off. This year, I do. I don't know how the fuck I managed that. But I like seeing my family. Even though I have to be up at like 7 in the morning, Christmas Day. Which is just gonna be a pain in the fucking ass. You're back, what'd you miss? We're still trying to break into a casino. Well, that's good at least. I'm running for my life and trying not to die. Hey guys. Fuck. I'm literally like trying not to fight them because there's no point. Cause I- fuck. I don't have the best agility, plus I keep getting my fucking feet, crippled because I took a perk that does that. I call dibs on the poke- no! My poker chips! I need them to gamble. I'm gonna go to Vegas one day. These poker chips are actually useful. Bye! Fuck! See ya. If the game had given me a shotgun, this would be a lot more- ow. If I keep moving, I- okay, keep me stopped. Close. Stopped. Okay. Vegas is cool. I have never been. My brother has. He went there to watch some Magic the Gathering tournament. Just to watch magic shows. Yeah, my brother went. He came out of fucking nowhere because I was living at home at the time. And then my parents were like, yeah, your brother's gonna be gone for a while. Or for like a weekend or something. And I'm like, oh, where's he going? And he's like, well, focus lens and super stim packed.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Damn transceivers. Let me link the callers to the speaker in the tower then. There.
I would never gamble. I've been playing Texas Hold'em since I was like 6. But I am very bad at it. I'm decent at blackjack, though.
I'll keep dog
I had to teach a bunch of old coworkers of mine how to play blackjack, and then I proceeded to kick their asses. Which is so weird, because, like, one of them claimed he knew, and he was the worst.
Finally.
God, I wish I had a shotgun. A riot shotgun would make this end segment so much easier. Okay, well, hope you like running. Because a bunch of enemies spawn after this, even the ones I didn't kill. Actually, these might just be the enemies I didn't kill. The game might not have respawned anybody. Normally I would kill them, but I am at level, I am at max level. There is no point. Sadly. Where the fuck am I? I'm tempted to just fucking just no clip. Oh, am I just screwed? It's coming way higher. Well, here's the thing. Where am I supposed to go? Like, my stats are pretty high. This is the intended route. You just phase through the walls. There. Getting a lot of perks. That's fun. I don't know, like, so I used to play with my specials all at 10, because that was always fun. Alright, that gives me that. It makes the game comically easy, but it's fun. Ooh, that's good. Damn, I could speedrun. Yeah, dude, I could. If only speedrunning allowed, no clipping. I try not to, cause like, but Dead Money's kind of bad at that. It's a very small area, but it's jam-packed full of stuff. I almost wanted to try to speedrun this game, but the fucking strats are insane. I don't think I could pull them off, even though I tried. It's like, I thought I could do a speedrun of one of the Fire Emblem games, cause I'm pretty good at the game, but like, no. No. Fun fact, I don't think God Mode actually- where the fuck am I going? I don't think God Mode actually saves you from the beeping. Okay. Peggle speedrun. Wait! How am I still getting damaged? Uh-oh. I might have fucked myself over. Oh, I can just do this. How do you speed... Oh, fuck. How do you speedrun Peggle? Why is my health still going down? Uh-oh. Happened. I died. I think I messed with the game too much. And now I'm like. It's fast geometry. Okay, hold on. I think I have a plan to survive this. So let's jack my health up. Do I remember what God code, what God mode is? I don't. Alright. My health is still going down. I'm gonna die again. I fucked with the game too much. Hold on. What is the fucking... Oh, I was so close. Okay. Alright. I figured it out the last minute. Alright, let's get rid of some shit. Okay. I think I brought... Oh god, I'm just gonna have to do this in God mode. What did I do? Okay, so like, I clearly don't have... Okay, hold on. So I clearly, I added dog. Check out sound low, reload in the air. I actually can't. Yeah, I'm stuck here. Okay, so let's turn God mode off. Yeah, so for some reason, I have to make dog mode. I'm now actually scared. Let's load this again from here. No god mode. So god mode is disabled, or... No, sums up. Yeah, I've never seen this glitch before in my life. I guess we're doing the rest of this in god mode. I forget, does this actually kill me even with god mode on?
You inside. Can you hear me? Now is fluctuating emergency power. Oh, you are in. Good. But that might be the end of you.
Nah, I'm good.
Unfortunately, your friends.
I think something with the sequence breaking fucked something up. I'm pretty sure that was on my part.
Wondering what happened. You were hit by casino security. Detects anything far, radioactive. It subdues the visitor, moves them if needed.
Oh, you found a fix? Okay.
Getting interference from all
hold on. I gotta get my thing closer to see this.
Shut that noise off. Looks like the casino moved your friends around once inside. Might be useful or not. Wonder if they came to help or kill you. Still, my signal should work through the speakers now that you're inside. Welcome to the Sierra Madre in all its glory. This is what the old world stood for, even with bombs.
Oh, do I have to do both at the same time?
Now, look at it. Beautiful now as guests are all dead. Better this way. Quiet. How the Mojave should be. Now, the casino is sleeping. It's got
places
closed off. Won't let you go yet.
What the hell?
Get there. Trust me. Just need to wake it up.
Am I spelling something wrong? Oh. I was about to say, those don't look too much like the command prompts I'm used to. Whatever, I'll just play in god mode and hope nothing else fucks up. I have never had this glitch before in my life. Well, Elijah should be really easy. Actually, this means I can just use whatever weapon I want.
This is the past you're walking through. Few have ever seen it. No one else ever. I worked hard to get here.
You did? What? You kidnapped a bunch of people. Just trying to leave
now. Now, look for a way to wake this ghost up. Remind it, it's got guests.
Now I gotta look. I probably could now. Yep, I'm also immune to the insta-kill damage. So the only hope right now is to kind of hope that, Yeah, the only hope right now is hopefully when I finish this... This goes away. I mean, to be completely honest, that's not the worst thing in the world. Invincible holograms. Yeah, those are a thing now. Welcome to the Sierra Madre. Welcome to how annoying it is. I think now they officially stop attacking you.
Damn recordings. Dead echoes in the frequencies. Casino security is shutting down, opening up its vendor and gambling programs in the back casino. still might be something for sale.
I think if I go...
After you're done looking around, head to the lobby.
I think I can buy something from you. I forgot what it is. Nothing useful. Yeah, I'm even immune to the insta-kill damage. That's actually pretty great. Alright, we're going to do another save. I'm kind of wondering... So if it's triggered to the start of the quest... Okay, well, it's still active. That's cool. If it's triggered to the start of the quest, my assumption is that it should go away once I finish it. Oh, well. Anyone want to watch a guy super cheat in fucking New Vegas?
Wondering what happened to your team? Looks like they got moved to other floors. Interesting.
Well, it's gonna be a cleaner run, but... Yeah, what the fuck? Oh, it must have had something to do with how I entered the trigger. Maintenance cube. Okay, I got work in the morning. Alright, man. I still gotta go a bit longer. I kinda wanna finish this, actually. Link to that fix. Yeah. Hand it, yeah. Just hand me the, yeah, if you got a link or something, because that would be super useful. So I don't plus play in God mode. I don't know what my load order is. Cool. Well, I'm gonna keep that save just in case we need it. God, if I have to play the rest of my New Vegas streams like this, where the fuck am I supposed to go? Just always God mode? Yeah, we don't actually have that much left. Could this be the last New Vegas stream? Where the fuck am I going? This isn't the right spot. I don't think it is. That didn't do shit. Okay.
That idiot's opened the gas valves. A single spark, or he sets off his comma. The casino's going to burn. Us, along with him.
All fire. You? Master. No, not Master.
Master.
Dog
Evil.
Remembers you. Kind to dog. Dog can't do this. Yes.
He can do it. I wonder if I get the personalities
you
to merge.
You caused this. Coddled him. Protected him.
It's just kind of hard if I merge. I'm really hoping that if I leave, this will stop.
You need to go. Run. Dog is going to burn voice.
Burn it away.
Burn voice out. Burn it away.
Dog is Dude, if you do this, you're going to die, dog.
Tired of being in another cage again.
Try to.
Kill this human, dog.
Kill him.
Kill them. If this casino is destroyed, good.
No,
it'll
but we want the casino.
The one who shouts at dog, the voice shouts, and to stop the voice, dog needs to burn it out.
Good lord, that's a stupid solution. I'll burn you.
Dog tried to shut it out.
No, dog, but you are the voice.
To make it quiet. Shh, dog. Let me.
He has like four endings. I think the most
Why
out of anybody.
You feed on this human when we're done. Master? Master, dog hoped you would come. Voice is going.
No.
To stop you. You think your pull is stronger than mine? No. No, I've minded Dog. Protected him far longer than you ever have. He won't listen to you. If Master sent you, Dog.
Dude, the Master did send me.
Dog can see.
See the voice. It looked like Dog.
Dog looks just like me.
Oh, we're gonna get them become friends. And fuse them together.
In the water, Dog understands.
If you get Dog as the only personality, his ending is like he eats entire communities.
If Dog is right. If you merge.
Which is like so funny to me.
Sierra Madre's end.
We'll be fine.
And Dog doesn't want to unremember you. May forget you. We will forget almost all that has happened here. You'll be alone.
We'll figure it out. We're resourceful guys.
Like Dog. Like me.
I don't want you under control.
The time you were there, and so close together. Who are you?
I can't believe I actually managed.
I feel as if I've woken up. I don't know you, yet I feel like I do, and a feeling of gratitude.
Wow, I can't believe I had the speech checks for that.
I'm wounded. This chain. This bear trap
around my arm.
How did I even get this far with these wounds? The pain is excruciating.
I love that. He's just like fucking half dead.
Rest for a moment. Thank you for whatever you have done.
Thank you, Dog. God. I don't really need anything else from that. I'm gonna grab 10 chips. I think it is still injuring me. What the hell? Oh, I have to repair all the gas valves still. Why did the game say I was good if I still had to do that? I don't even know where they all are. Is there a gas valve in the freezer? Do I want to know? Am I allowed to leave now? Yes. I'm free. We're free, Dog. God. They look like coins.
You've got one of the floors reestablished. Good. Accessing the music archives now. Two more to go. Oh, it seems the casino has uninvited guests. The villa inhabitants were pounding at the doors.
Now they know. Now they have a way in.
Is that ghoul still alive?
Probably. We'll see if we can succeed on his check. It has to be the front one at all times. Why is the battle music playing? Wow, so mean. What'd this poor guy ever do to you? He actually helped us. Why am I going against him? God, it feels so weird playing with God mode on. I mean, like, I played casually with God mode on, but not like... But not a lot of times. It's really just to get through stuff I don't feel like dealing with. Or like just to make a segment more fun. Man, they really don't help you on this, do they? What do you mean? Why does everything require a fucking key? Whoops, I cheated again. Oh, I did not. Alright, Domino, where's my fucking... Where's the key? I can't just get back behind this curtain. Are you serious? Come on, Dini.
Door sealed. Must be a key to the backstage. Hunt for it.
Oh, that's where it is. Okay.
Finally, a friendly face. Hey, partner.
Hey.
They're in a bit of a predicament here. Had to duck backstage, take a powder. The audience.
Dude, you're doing cocaine?
Murderous tonight.
Yeah, not good.
Idea.
What do you mean you woke up here?
I was dreaming for a second. Right back on the stage. The mic. Thought I was back at the Franz.
The Franz?
Well, except no audience used to pack theaters back then. So, stepped up on the stage, checked things out. Then suddenly, holograms walked.
Yeah, those fucking holograms.
They started raising their hands to their heads, all creepy-like.
That is odd. What are you talking about?
Look, those ghosts are going to come out of the wings behind you in a second. Security types, not the friendly, bald types. And if you got in here, the door's probably locked tight behind you. So don't back up or run for the exit. You're not going to make it.
Yeah, we're all gonna die.
Trust me, as soon as you can, run to the door to the left. Use the key you got out of the music rag there and camp out. As bad as things
the
are,
left.
It's going to get a lot worse if either of us pops. So get backstage. Till we get a better plan.
A better plan? What's the plan? To die? It's probably to die. I was gonna say, it's gotta be your left. Yeah, I'm gonna raid your safe, Dean. A blackmail tape. Give me the fucking ammo box. Why does he have an ammo box here? Watch that be what fucked me up. Where the fuck are we? I'm serious, what the hell? Found something. Just go. The weird thing is I don't have to reload anymore, but I probably will press the reload button like 6 more times. went through my... I hope that was the right door. It only requires key. Did I have the right key? Have fun, dipshits. Is that a book? It's so weird that this is how you get to calm them down. Can't even get back there. I did what you asked.
Now, deal with the ghoul. This has gone on long enough.
Alright, we'll see if I'll get the ending I want, which is everybody lives. I'll try.
Oh, those electric ghosts aren't the kind of audience I like.
I don't know if I can. I'm usually not that good. At least the ones in the villa had
manners. Don't even know how I ended up here. Guess the casino still recognizes guests, even after all this
time. So you're a singer here.
How's that for history? Yeah, now. Talk about a captive
audience. Or captive entertainer.
Whatever. Look, I'm more about the short goodbyes than long thankful speeches. But
did I really get it? Did I really do it?
A tight spot there, partner. I know you didn't do it out of the goodness of your heart. So let me give you something a little more practical. A way we both come out ahead.
I'm listening.
I'm not an idiot. I know the reason I'm in here now is because of the old guy.
Yes. Damn it.
And you're wearing a collar, so I trust you a little more than the old guy.
Hey, Sam.
He's more controlling than I'd like. Thing is, here's where being my partner pays off. See, I know how to get into the casino vault.
Hell yeah.
There's a private elevator, Sinclair's. It's up in the executive suite.
Sweet in Vera's room.
Not a coincidence.
Nope.
Vera. She was...
Well, not willingly.
...other partner before the bomb. Took some legwork. Some convincing made it happen.
Blackmail. You blackmailed her. Literally.
Sinclair was already puppy-eyed, so all I had to do was the introductions. She smiled, fluttered her eyes, showed a little leg, and he built this whole place for her. Made her the key to his vault, like a joke, because of her name. Her fake
Hollywood name.
Except Sinclair didn't know I'd been there first. I could twist her.
Yeah, you're a dick.
The direction I wanted. All she had to do was get inside the Sierra Madre
for the gala.
Then use her voice to open the door.
Then from that, smooth sailing.
Would have been the biggest heist in history.
Claire left holding the bag. Ruined. So what happened?
The bomb. Vera got sealed in here.
Damn!
A few hundred years go by, give or take. Almost the end of the story.
Yeah, so he blackmails Vera because he finds out Vera's been taking drugs, but not because of an addiction, but because of a medical problem. Sinclair is just a good guy, and Dean is just pissed that Sinclair is a happy man. He's just a petty dick.
Problem? All high and mighty. Lording it over everyone. Acting so
self-righteous.
Like nothing could touch him. He was the one with the problem. Never got mad at anything. Nothing seemed to shake him. Even after...
His life kept getting dragged through the dirt. Always kept looking for the bright, shining future in everything.
Because he was an optimist, Dean wanted him fucked.
I decided to take everything from him. Do to me. What, weren't you listening? He thought he was better than me.
He didn't.
Don't believe me?
Look around.
This big casino. This big, colossal monument.
Fun fact. It is. It's literally all for Vera, as you find out if you read the audio, the stuff. Like, he literally just did it all for her.
Fit him perfect. Had to take him down a few pegs. Bring him down to my level.
He's just a dick.
Begin again. Some things you don't get up from.
Domino would be a more interesting character if there was more to him, but there really isn't. Like, he's just kind of a petty dick, and that's, like, it.
Man showed up. You showed up. Then that woman showed up.
It's scars. Oh, my God.
The one who makes all the hand signs a little tight around the corners of her mouth.
I just, like, cracked my jaw.
Tuned her like an instrument.
Oh, it did not feel good.
If she heals up, it's not going to be her voice speaking anymore. That is, if the Sierra Madre didn't get her. If it did, well, there's enough of Vera around for me to spend a few years piecing a book together.
We just need her voice.
Then
I did not listen to Dog's story. Whoops.
I'm not banking on it. So here's the short of it. Piece together Little Miss Vera Key's
soul. Yeah, Dog is just a soldier in the Master's army, and we actually got most of the story that we got from
yeah, little bit of two real memories. We're here to steal from the Sierra Madre, not from each other.
True.
Go. I'm just gonna catch my breath a bit.
Oh, did I actually get him to survive? Okay. Damn, I was not expecting that. Yeah, I guess I never condescended him or passed any of those speech checks, so that made it a lot easier. Hey, that's good for me. I didn't really want to fucking try to mess with that.
Deal with them. And don't try and leave yourself. Almost have the entirety of what I need from the musical.
You guys are just gonna talk over each other, huh? The archives together at the main floor. Yes, I heard all of that.
You can deal with her. She's somewhere on this floor. Floor is buzzing with emitter signatures. Watch out for holograms.
I'll be fine.
This is Christine. We're covered. In what looks like an old world hotel room.
Huh. Hold on, I wonder.
Should be able to rewire them.
Yeah, it's still not working.
Although, that'll alert the others. They're on a linked patrol pattern. The floor looks like it protected the guests.
Okay, that's not good.
Check the suite. Found a holographic woman Sinclair. In the middle of fountain. Sinclair. Picking up that interference.
God, security systems won't let me out. They're keeping me here.
Well, yeah, that's what security systems do. Wait, no, that's not what they do. Having fun trying to kill me? Well, I'm trying to find a way out. But I need your help.
They're keeping me here.
Yeah, keep saying that, huh? I dealt with that. What the fuck, game? What the hell? I'm very confused. I'm pretty sure I did all that. I love when there's like two left. I don't know if that helped, like, at all. It requires key. Okay. Well, it's not the emergency doors. But I dealt with that. Game. I did the gas down below. What the hell?
Made it. Good.
What's good about it?
I'll keep this quick in case my voice goes out.
Do you have a voice?
Do I? It sounds off to my ears.
Well, yeah, because it's not like your voice. I'm sure if I had a different voice, it would sound off.
Hell to swallow. Might be why I got moved off to this suite. It's hers. That's her over there. Got trapped by security like I did.
Damn.
Different way out.
Killed herself.
Good luck. He's not an easy opponent.
He'll be fine.
If I can, I'll help. Might be able to figure something out using the Sierra Madre's computer systems.
I know what I'm doing. Yeah, she just like kills herself. I'm pretty sure the Vera's dress is like the only unique item from this area. Actually, I just completed a quest, so... Nope.
This is Knight Christine Royce of the Brotherhood. Christine Royce.
Unlock security door. That was another version of her outfit. Audition when the war was on?
Alright. This is Vera Keys auditioning for Love Set Sail. Malcolm, ever since our freighter went down, I feel like my...
I don't want to hear any more of this garbage.
You're back.
So where am I going? Oh. God, they really make you run around for a lot of this shit. I dealt with this crap. They make you run around this
mission. That's all I need. Now, go to the main lobby terminal. Grab the music sequence together.
I had to do, and they will just destroy everything. Cool. Elijah, I hate to say this, but this casino sucks. I'll take it. I'll be happy. I must have forgotten one down below or something. Oh, it's a hologram.
You're back. You did. Looks like even... So, I just rasp back.
Yeah, just talk a little.
I know. The sealed doors, the security. Love makes people do strange
crazy things.
If they loved each other, and they were together. But she's in that side room, dead, because the casino wouldn't let her leave. And who knows where
St. Clair, I think, is dead.
Alright. I... the one who made these collars. He'll follow you down.
I'll kill him for you.
Look, you've done so much, and he's... I can't let go. I've lost him so many times.
Once was in the Big Empty. That was not your fault.
What happened? You have to promise me. All right. I... Never mind.
Aw, she's not gonna join us. I already got it to open. Can you, okay.
Again. No one to let go.
Let's rock. Hey, I saved all the companions. Fucking dope. Yeah, maintenance access. I can drink water before I can go to this final showdown. Oh, bullets, bullets, fuck. There's beeping down here too? What the hell? Worker's note. Where the fuck am I? I must have just no-clipped. I don't even know where this is supposed to be. It was like a straight shot. What the hell? I don't know what that is, but I'm gonna shoot it. I fucking... Okay, I don't know what that did. Are they hostile to me now, or? How do I get past here? It's like a job for Captain Noclip. I'm already cheating. There we go. Oh, wait, what? There we go. God, even bringing it in here would be annoying as hell. Because I'd have to deactivate all this stuff, and it'd just be a pain in the ass. More force fields. What the heck, game? How do I get past these ones? Does violence work? There we go. Okay. Like a generator over here, I think. Where's the generator? Why is it just a coffee mug? I don't know. I can just leave. Just be like, fuck it, I'm out. Peace. There's like a terminal or something I can do before I enter. Where the fuck is it? Oh, there's... He's dead down here. Sorry, buddy. I just stuck down here now. I think I can jump up. There we go. Yeah, there should be like a big terminal or something that I could use to like to turrets. Yeah, whatever. Who cares? Unlock the vault. I'm rich. Rich. You don't understand. I'm now super rich. Wow, look at that weight. I'm my god the mode. Oh, there it is. See if I can get this. Probably not, because ultra hard ones are pretty difficult. They don't leave you as many of these as you normally would have. I'll have to smash it. Alright, let's take all of the gold. Man, I need to open it up again. What the fuck? How the hell do I get out of here then? Let me out! Oh fuck, I got the...
You're in the vault, finally.
I almost thought I got the bad ending.
The Sierra Madre.
The Sierra Madre.
Mine. Don't move. Don't go into the vault and don't touch anything else.
But I already took all the money.
Another security system. Hiding?
You're hiding, dude. I know you're hiding. Oh, you've been in the casino the whole time.
Until your Pip-Boy signal came to life in the villa. Then
things changed.
And here you are. No.
I'm fucking asshole.
Chance while I'm so close. Not this close. No. Not again. You?
This is the only entrance, and I have free reign of the Sierra Madre.
I'm gonna fucking kill you.
There might be more traps. I'll set. No, I don't think so. It'd most likely trigger other security.
Dude, I will break this entire place to the ground. Maybe I just wanted to break shit.
You're curious. Past the threat. The collar? Even if you could kill yourself.
Clever.
Whoever designed the Sierra Madre, their obsession with messing with frequencies and signals. I'm coming down. I'll meet you face to face at the vault.
I want to see if I can do it. I'm like, I really don't know if this is possible. I don't even know where he is. All right.
What's this? Alarms. What? Think you can run? This entire structure is mine, Command.
You hear me down there?
Trying to help you out here. What the hell? I thought you would do that. You die. Okay, bye. That was really easy. I need to get the fuck out of here. What's the extracted holotape? Why are you making me go the long way? Why is it exploding? Go down. I can't remember. I really cannot remember how to get out of here. Yeah, the Sierra Madre is not long for this world. Not after all, which is what I just did. Game. I'm gonna die. Nope, still there. You are over encumbered. I'm well aware of this. Let's get the fuck out of here. That's not out. Yeah, you can do like one last sweep of the area if there's anything you missed, which we're not gonna do. We're just gonna leave. Sayonara, suckers. Return to the Mojave.
The survivors of the Sierra Madre thought about gathering at the fountain and waiting for the courier. In the end, the caller's silence made them uneasy, and the fear of turning on each other made them hesitate and leave the goodbyes unspoken. The radio message at the fountain was enough for them, and there was no need to add another farewell on top of all they had suffered.
Dog forgot himself. As did the voice that raged within him. After that,
I actually got the good ending. Weird.
A new voice spoke within the mutant shell. It was difficult for the voice to remember the two it once was.
But
there was the beast, Dog, consumed by hunger. And the other in reverse.
The reverse? One
consumed by control. Both were driven.
Damn, I just realized I'm probably not going to get the achievements because I had to use God mode because of the glitch.
Join the two into one. All that happened at the Sierra Madre was a faint memory to the new personality. Like a flickering light in the clouds of the mind. The new voice did not think of the courier again until the battle of the divide reached his ears. The battle between the two couriers, beneath the torn skies and the old world flag,
each bearing a message for the other.
And the mutant prayed the courier that had saved him had been saved.
Boy, we're gonna do that one next. That's gonna be fun.
Dean Domino, entertainer, singer, thief, explored the Sierra Madre not long after he was rescued by the courier. Once he left the theater, the Sierra Madre recognized him as a guest, and many doors opened
to him.
He had to admit
it had been built to last.
During his search, he came across the final records of Vera and Sinclair and realized what happened the night the bombs
fell.
He felt strangely sad for a moment, and he had no idea
why.
Shrugging it off, his mind turned instead to where the courier had come
from. I kind of wish if you had him live, he could be found in the Mojave.
Out there in the Mojave.
Like, it'd be cool to see him at the casinos.
It sights. Sounds
like it would be cool to like see him in Freeside and maybe get a quest of like getting him into Vegas or something.
So, giving the Sierra Madre one last nod and a wink, he set off beyond the cloud to begin again.
Christine, her mission complete. Found new purpose.
Yeah, she kind of just stays in the Sierra Madre.
She watched over it silently, by choice, over time. The ghost people came to see her as one of the holograms. They would
watch
silently as she walked among them. At times, Christine thought of the courier, who had kept Elijah's hand from her throat. The courier reminded her of the other courier she had met in the Big Empty.
Which we will get to. That's Elijah.
Found each other at last.
Yeah, they fought.
She did not think of them again until she heard the legends of the Divide.
The fucking Divide.
Where the two messengers... Two couriers fought beneath an ancient flag at the edge of the world.
I mean, it's a pretty good DLC.
You heard of the Sierra Madre Casino?
We all have.
The legends. The curses. Yeah, this one's not very long either.
Some foolishness about it lying in the middle of a city of dead.
A city of ghosts. Beneath a blood-red cloud.
Bright shining monument.
Which is bugged as fuck. Great.
Luring treasure hunters to their
I should have done two saves. No crashes. What the hell?
A promise that you can change your fortunes.
Begin again.
Finding it though.
That's not the hard part.
That's not the hard part. It's letting go.
It's letting go of one's past.
It's letting go.
Wait a moment. Before you go, we hope you've enjoyed yourself. Farewells can be a time of sadness. Letting go, difficult. As a guest of the Sierra Madre, you know that truth more than anyone.
Yep. Yeah, this opens up after the DLC, and you, like, get access to some things. Yeah, just another pair of his robes. I think something else opens up, but I can't remember what it was. And that is all for this. I'm gonna do one final thing. And that is we're gonna go deposit some of this shit. That Dropbox, I believe, gets restocked, so you can still use the Sierra Madre. Then I think all the equipment is here. Oh, now I got it all. Oh my god, do I have a lot of shit. me get my old stuff back on. Yeah, we're gonna go deposit some stuff. We are not gonna sell the gold bars. Those are a victory trophy. But yeah, that was Dead Money. Dead Money is widely considered to be the, I guess, the least popular of the four. Mostly because it strips you of all your gear and you kind of have to... It changes its gameplay a lot, which some people find pretty annoying. But I'm on two minds about it. I originally really did not like it. And, I'm still under those minds, to be completely honest. Not just for the glitch. It's just irritating. There's a lot of issues it has, especially if you're playing a non-melee build character, because melee is just so good in that it just becomes ridiculous. The gold at the end is funny too, because it's supposed to symbolize, like, you're supposed to let go of the gold. You're not supposed to take it. And then people have spent, like, actual time calculating how much you can take out of there realistically. Like, it's just funny to me. Any of the grenades I'm just going to keep, because... Yeah, you're gonna watch, like, you're gonna be like, oh, man. Where's all the weight? I know where it is. So, where the fuck is the gold? Gold bars! Yeah, so that gets me right back to normal weight. Yeah, it's a pretty good DLC, to be completely honest. I might, if I'm in a different location next time, it might just be because I am doing something. Probably trying to make that fix. I'm going to hope, and I'm going to pray, that exiting the game causes all of these problems to go away. This will sadly be the only stream of the week. Sadly. Then that's just because of holidays and I work, so that's just what it's gonna be. I do apologize for that. But yeah, that's gonna kind of be it. If for some reason my plans for New Year's Eve fall through, then I might stream then. And that will be Fire Emblem, so. And I will see you guys all next week sometime. I'm not entirely sure when that will be, so. Yep, see you guys later.